Hello everyone, myself Sugnyan Shivayogi Abhigiri. In this video, we will solve a previous year JMN question. This question appeared in 2019 JMN paper. Let's have a look at the question. A parallel plate capacitor with plates of area 1 meter square each are at a separation of 0.1 meter. Parallel plate capacitor means we take two plates which are rectangular or either square in shape, and we are keeping them at some distance between them, or we are maintaining some separation between them and connecting to a battery and completing the circuit. So this we can say it as a parallel plate capacitor. These two plates combine to form a parallel plate capacitor, and this is a battery. This completes the whole circuit. Given in the question that the plates have an area of 1 meter square each, we represent this area with capital A. Let me write it here once again. A is equal to 1 meter square. Next, these are kept at a separation of 0.1 meter, which is represented by letter small d. Means these have a separation of 0.1 meter. Or distance between them is 0.1 meters. Next, if the electric field between the plates is 100 newton per coulomb, the magnitude of charge on each plate is. Now, electric field is given. Let me explain why this electric field plays a role here. Whenever a battery is connected to a capacitor, charges flow and settle on this plate. Whenever charges settle on this plate, there is an electric field between these charges. Due to the charges, there will be some electric field created. So that value is 100 newton per coulomb. Generally, we represent electric field with capital letter E, which is 100 newton per coulomb. Here we can draw electric field with dotted lines also. These dotted lines represent the electric field between the plates, which is given 100 newton per coulomb. And finally, we should find the magnitude of charge on each plate. Whenever we connect a battery to a parallel plate capacitor, charges equal in magnitude are formed on both the plates, that is Q and Q. But these charges are opposite in their signs. Here, plus Q charge is formed, but on the other plate, minus Q charge is formed. But we don't need any signs. Question is directly asking us to find only the magnitude, means simply we should find the value of Q. Now, for any capacitor, whether it is a spherical or parallel plate or cylindrical, there is one basic formula which can be applied to any capacitor, that is C is equal to Q by V. This is charge on capacitor, this is the voltage between the two bodies or two plates here, and C is the capacitance. Here in this question, we need to find the value of Q, but we neither have the value of voltage V or potential difference, neither we have the value of capacitance. But we have the electric field value, that is 100 newtons per coulomb. So we can take out the value of V or electric potential difference or voltage from this electric field. Let me show you how to do that. First, we will write the basic formula for electric field, that is KQ by R square. Means if any two bodies, let this be two bodies, anything P and Q, and distance is R between them. This one I am taking for example for your understanding sake. So electric field acting between these two bodies will be KQ by R square, and potential between these will be KQ by R. Q is the charge on any particle, R is the distance between them. Now we should relate these two and get the value of voltage. So let me write it KQ by R into R. Now let me write the electric field as KQ by R square is there, na? Let me write it as R into R. Now we can observe that here KQ by R, it can be replaced by V, because V is also equal to KQ by R only. Let me write it here. E is equal to, in place of KQ by R, we will write V divided by R. V is the voltage, R is the distance between any two bodies, E is the electric field acting between them. But we only want the value of V here. V can be written as E into R. But in this question, distance between the plates is given by small d. V is equal to E into d, right? Now let me apply this here. C is equal to Q by V. वी नो दैट वैल्यू ऑफ वी और पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस इज इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ई इंटू डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दैम बी वी हैव डिराइव्ड इट हियर बाय टेकिंग वन सिंपल एग्जाम्पल. सो नाउ सी इज इक्वल टू क्यू वैल्यू वी शुड फाइंड. इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड वैल्यू इज गिवन 100 एंड डिस्टेंस इज गिवन एज 0.1 meter. दिस इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द प्लेट्स. फाइनली द वैल्यू ऑफ सी विल बी क्यू डिवाइडेड बाई 10. वी वॉन्ट द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू इन द क्वेश्चन राइट. क्यू इज इक्वल टू 10 C. वी गॉट द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू इन टर्म्स ऑफ सी बट वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ सी. इफ वी फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ सी देन ओनली वी विल गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू. नाउ वी शुड अप्लाई द कैपेसिटेंस फॉर्मूला इन केस ऑफ पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर्स. लेट मी राइट इट हियर. सी इज इक्वल टू ए एप्सिलॉन नॉट बाय डी. देर आर टू फॉर्मूलाज फॉर कैपेसिटेंस और सी दैट इज क्यू बाय वी एंड ए एप्सिलॉन नॉट बाय डी. वी शुड अप्लाई दिस फॉर्मूला ओनली वेन पैरेलल प्लेट कैपेसिटर्स इज गिवन. वी शुड नॉट अप्लाई दिस फॉर स्पेरिकल कैपेसिटर्स और सिलेंड्रिकल कैपेसिटर्स. दिस formula is valid only for parallel plate capacitors but this one is basic formula we can apply anywhere. So from this equation we can find out the value of C. Here A represents area of the plates, epsilon naught means permittivity of the space between these two plates. Here they did not give any dielectric medium such as water, oil or something etc. means capacitor is not placed in water or oil or any liquids or any gases. Means we can assume that it is placed in common air or vacuum. So for vacuum permittivity value will come near 8.86 × 10⁻². But in the question they have given that we should take the epsilon naught value or permittivity value as 8.85 × 10⁻². only. And area value we have been given in the question, that is 1 m² capital A and distance is 0.1 m. So let us put the values in this equation and get the value of C. A is 1, epsilon naught as the value given in this question, 8.85 × 10⁻². divided by D, that is 0.1. Now C can be written as 8.85 × 10⁻². divided by 0.1 can also be written as 10⁻¹. 8.85 × 10⁻². I will send this 10⁻¹ to the numerator. If we send it, then this negative sign of the power will change into positive. Means 10⁻¹ will become 10⁻¹. After multiplying this, we'll get 8.85 × 10⁻¹⁺ farads. This will be the value of capacitance of these two plates. Farads means it is a unit for measuring capacitance. Like we measure length in meters, weight in kilograms or newtons like that, mass in kilograms like that. We measure capacitance in farads. Now, if we put the value of C in this equation, we will get the value of Q. Let this be equation 1 and let this be equation 2. Put equation 2 in equation 1. Let me write equation 1 once again here. Q is equal to 10C. Q is equal to 10 into C value we have find out here. 8.85 × 10⁻¹. This one is −11. 8.85 × 10⁻¹. Now final value of Q will be 8.85 × 10⁻¹⁰ coulombs. This will be the magnitude of charge on the plates. This is the final answer. Let us look at the options, if any option matches with our answer or not. Yes, the fourth option, 8.85 × 10⁻¹⁰ coulombs, matches with our option. Option 4. Now, let me summarize this, what we have done here. we have been given area, we have been given the suppression distance, we have also been given the field. But for any basic capacitance, we need their charge and voltage. Here we need charge. So we must need their capacitance and their voltage. But these two values have been not given to us. But we have been given the value of electric field. From electric field, we have derived the voltage here. And we have put this value here in this equation. After that, we got Q in terms of C. Now again, we applied parallel plate formula capacitance. And we have got the value of C, 8.85 × 10⁻¹⁷ farads. Now we have put the value of C in equation 1. Means we have multiplied 10 to C and we got Q. This was the final answer for this question. Option 4 is the right answer. In this question, we mainly applied 3 concepts. That is, the first concept was relation between voltage and electric field. We derived a relation here, voltage and electric field. Second concept, we applied the basic formula of capacitance, that is charge by potential difference or voltage. And third concept was the concept to calculate or the formula to calculate the capacitance of parallel plate capacitor. We interrelated these three concepts and finally we got the answer. Hope you all enjoyed this video and hope you all enjoyed solving this question. If you have any doubts in this solution, please share them in the comment box. I will do my best to clear your doubts. And if you have any question that needs to be solved, please mention that also in the comment box. I will solve that question in next upcoming videos. So guys, thanks for watching this video. Stay home, stay safe, be healthy. This is Sugnyan Shivayogi Abhigiri signing off. Take care. Thank you.